depends, and you get good pressure in the early game.
I think it depends on
good
when,
option.
When the next core is picked. Because if we assume that it's double support from Secret, they haven't picked a single core, which leaves them more flexible right now than Liquid. So if Liquid show a core, I think that's when they decide what the Doom actually does.
I actually think that the Doom...
Secret have to pick next time.
The Doom is going to have a very good chance of becoming a core because they're messing around with Liquid.
Okay, so if you have to pick a core next, you probably pick your mid matchup because you know what it is, right?
So you put Weeha on Windranger?
I really like Windranger for them.
Yeah, she's pretty good here. You know what's also good?
But I like TA though. I think TA was just... What?
He wants Puck.
Ding, ding, oh, ding. It's good.
Nah.
It's not as good here as it's been a lot of other times. But it's still...
I mean, if you want to crush the lane and they're on Dire, I would prefer TA. Like, against Invoker, it's a very good matchup for him.
That's actually a good idea. I like that.
Good rush potential, too.
Mm-hmm. I haven't really seen him play the hero, though. I don't think... Has he ever played the hero?
I'm pretty sure he's played before.
They met it themselves.
Okay, support Doom.
Could still be safe lane.
Yes.
They have good auras. If they want to put a core mid that can deal damage, it's entirely possible, and that they're just trying to trick Liquid. I like that idea a lot because Liquid will probably be completely drafting around the anticipation that this is support Doom because they just saw it.
But how good is the safe lane Doom?
I think it's pretty good. In a way, so now that you don't have level death anymore, I don't think I've seen a single safe lane Doom since Infernal Blade in competitive games compared to level death. In a way, safe lane Doom is even better now because you get levels early and Infernal Blade is ownage. So
a quick statistic update, they have not picked TA in 3 months.
3 months? All right, okay, they're never going to pick the hero.
Time to bring it out now.
They just picked Ursa like 2 games ago, dude.
And they picked Earth Spirit.
And they picked Doom for the first time yesterday in 2 years.
Okay, so it's entirely possible that we see a TA.
It is possible. Now it's less likely. Oh, I don't know. I think this support duo was godly. At Frankfurt.
Even at TI.
Yeah. I don't like it so much anymore.
Too defensive?
It's like, you know, on paper it's good. I just feel like when you see it, it doesn't do that well. I've seen various teams play it and I feel like they always end up losing. Simply because you have a lot of defensive with Snowball and Grave, which in theory is great, but... neither of the heroes scales at all. So late game supporting you, which of these two heroes do you want farm on?
Maybe they want a call that scales
Dazzle
very well.
Leader.
Like, no, maybe they want a call that scales very well, like PL, and works very well with Dazzle. And you have a lot of, because you have a lot of single targets, right? You have Doom and Beastmaster. They are not so good versus Illusion heroes. So maybe they want PL. That's why they went for the Dazzle.
Oh, PL is pretty cool. I like that.
I don't know. I feel that might be an idea, but
let's play Naga.
I have a question.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
What is Mind Control gonna play? No Tide, no Darkseer, no Beastmaster?
He's played Tusk in the past Prophet? When they don't have another offline option. If Liquid want to pick a different support.
Void is still in?
Yeah, Void.
This
but Void's... Yeah.
He's pretty ass here.
It's okay. You have Invoker.
And Heroes.
Void is... You don't think Void's good?
Not really against
They just don't have a lot of
Yeah,
power.
Because they don't have a lot of, yeah, they don't
they
have
could,
a lot of damage.
They could
they have so many counters to him, too.
They could pick Gyro and then Void last. I don't know.
They could do, like, Nightstalker, too. They can also do maybe an offlane Phoenix.
It's like you don't want to play Void against that lineup. That's just horrible. There are actually 3 heroes that can solo.
I don't like Void.
I think more so is like their team as well. They don't have anyone else to do damage except for the Invoker. So they need an offlane. Not that much though. I don't think they will do offlane Lone Druid.
It's true.
Probably safe lane. But I'm leaning a bit towards the PL because their heroes are all single target now, and they have Dazzle.
They've played Mind Control Gyro.
Oh yeah.
Where they did an aggressive tri lane with it. Yeah. I kind of like that idea here.
Hmm.
It's a way of
Gyro
punishing
Dazzle
the fact that they have a Doom. If they're expecting this to be a jungle Doom, they could go for that and just put the Gyro in that position, and then they could like. In theory, try to outgreed Secret by having both the Gyro and then even a PL, if you like that, is possible, or someone else. Okay, I am not a fan of this game.
They're just gonna pick a safe lane hero that actually has follow-up damage. Like, I would be surprised if Secret let Gyro through here.
Gyro is the obvious one.
Okay, put yourself in the Void's place in this game. Now you have to play Void. If there's a Hawk on you, you're dead. You can get jumped by literally Lion, Doom, Beastmaster, or Windranger. Almost all of them can solo you from full to zero.
Shackle, Hex, Doom.
Shackle, Focus Fire.
One good
roar,
news.
Necro,
Snowball.
Doom can kill you.
One Lion good news about Void this game.
Finger you.
Doom is going to roam, so you're going to have a dual lane. Void will be able to farm.
Sure, he will get something, I think. But the risk is just you. For your Void to pay off, you either need to crush your lane or you need to get Chronos in the mid game.
Blink.
I think Secret can they'll see him almost all game. It's similar to last game with the Tide, where they doomed the Tide, and the way they found him was with Clinks or with the Nature's Prophet. This time they'll find him with Hawk instead. It's pretty similar.
What do you think about a Medusa in this scenario?
For Secret?
No, for Liquid.
Great.
No.
If you can get away with it.
No,
how are you gonna get away with it? I don't think you can get away with it.
They have Mana Drain. Doom is pretty good against Medusa.
You're buying Book for 3 as well.
They're buying
Beastmaster.
Book, a Beast.
I don't think Doom's good for Medusa at all.
I think it's okay.
Alright.
So, okay.
It's a good thing about Nautilus then.
I think the Mana Drain is pretty good.
But can Jackie be greedy? More greedy with his carry here in this game? Or do you think that they still need
I think they could go Slark or something, honestly. Like, I don't see Liquid's lineup pressuring that hard. 10 seconds
remaining. They don't have much kill potential. Like,
yeah, that's what I mean. Like, how are they gonna pressure lanes? I think they could pick something like even AM, like
just
terribly.
Just be greedy, yeah.
Just be super greedy.
AM. That's why I'm asking if you think it's possible to get away this game.
Like, what safe lane can Liquid pick to pressure this game? Lycan's banned, Gyro's banned. They don't have Spectre either for ultra late.
Not much. Joranger
doesn't. That's why I was curious.
Joranger doesn't feel
Ember.
Good.
Ember's still the
pool. That's why I was curious if they pick
Slark.
Let's use the Slark.
It is.
I keep throwing my headset. It's not great.
So what's safe lane? All right,
Secret,
oh
before
God.
You ask me, no matter what Liquid pick, I favor Secret this game.
Okay, yes, I wasn't going to ask
Man,
the team name,
they're
though.
All going to be on the same boat here.
But you will say yes to my question, then.
Depends. What's your question?
I'm going to ask if Secret is going to be your Shanghai Major champion.
Yes.
After this draft, I believe so. Yes.
Okay. Now the issue is like, no matter what, it's the last pick. Oh, this is the only last. Yeah, we were talking about what heroes they can pair.
Slark's actually
throw.
Good against that hero.
But their heroes are just so hard to. Oh my
hey,
god.
Hey, Syndrome. Yeah. Is Secret going to be your Shanghai Major
okay,
champion?
Okay, just to expand very quickly, I think this is the biggest outdraft of the final.
In the series, yes. Agree.
Yep,
Secret's going to be the champion.
Oh, wow. Are you going to jump on that train?
Yep.
Ben is on us.
No disagreement.
4-0.
Let's find out if our commentators have the same idea and maybe if Liquid can prove our analysts wrong. We're going to go to our fourth game here in the grand finals of the Shanghai Major, Team Secret versus Team Liquid with Capitalist and Blitz.
A long time ago, Puppy and Kuro used to be on a team together when our scene was infinitely smaller. It's only fitting now that we now are able to host thousands in stadiums to watch Dota 2 that these two legends face up against each other one more time. Kuro looking to be able to prove himself as a captain to his former teammates has no more chances as they can't afford any more mistakes. And we're hearing from our analysts that this is potentially the biggest outdraft of the finals. Blitz, it's looking dire for Liquid already, but do you feel the same?
Kind of. I feel like execution-wise, Secret have a much bigger window that they can get through just because the Slark matches up so well against the Drow Ranger later on into the game. And I don't know, man. This... Nobody's really figured out how to beat this Puppy Doom quite yet.
It's
and
certainly...
they've got Highlight Dies line again. Like, they've got all the comfort picks in the world for them, Secret.
This is going to be one of the faster-paced games that Liquid is going to have to be playing with this last pick, Drow Ranger. Do you feel like this was kind of desperation where Liquid were reading that perhaps they were outpicked and they just had to go in for an all-out kind of strategy to end the game fast?
I think they're just trying to push the tempo. In every single one of the games that they played so far, the tempo has been so slow. Secret have been taking advantage of that by just picking farming heroes and farming supports and allowing everybody to just like five-man farm. And even if Liquid get the occasional like good team fight off, they still start to fall behind. It's such a hard style to crack, especially in this kind of format. You don't have a lot of time to think about it.
Do you think that it would have been better for Team Liquid to go the opposite route, because I feel like they've been in position twice now to try and push the tempo of this game, keep the pace going as fast as possible so they can try and end the game before Team Secret get too big, and both times they've failed to really take control of the game, and Team Secret have just stalled the game out to a point where they have a gigantic net worth advantage. And now you're saying the Team Liquid, they're going to try and speed it up even more. It feels almost like maybe Team Liquid should have looked at slowing down the game even further.
I don't think they can really play that pace anymore. This entire tournament, they've been MVP Phoenix style, trying to just run at people nonstop. I don't think you change your strategy like too heavily.
Mm-hmm.
I know a lot of people are going to be like, why do they keep going for those heroes? Well, those are clearly the heroes that they practice. Like, they're not going to be like, oh, well, let's just do completely... Let's just...
You're on the grind final stage. You're going to stick with what you know.
Exactly. And hopefully they were able to make the play differences. In the last game, way too many mistakes in the first 2 minutes.
Yeah, certainly. Liquid, they lost control of that game pretty damn early. And maybe a team fighter there was able to help things out. But in the end, Secret always had the control. Looks like some early counter wards going to be laid down. An interesting ward being placed out here, as this is typically a ward that's going to be placed by the Dire side early on. But it does actually work out here for Liquid. They're going to be able to see some of these rotations without being counter warded. Mind Control's going to battle it out early with Pylai Dai, though not wanting to blow his early time walk, as he doesn't want to be zoned out of the lane entirely.
I think he was also trying to block the big camp from Puppy, as Misery and him are going to have a pretty crowded jungle, but Liquid, they really have to push the pace of this game. The laning phase has to go exceedingly well for them if they're going to make use of this Drow Ranger, and their Void can't even really make use of the aura either. He absolutely cannot. He's a melee hero, so he's just going to go to the jungle, but going to have to go to the opposite side of the jungle to get anything. Looks like both safe laners are just going to get absolute free farm once again, but I sort of think I favor the Slark again in this.
Slark is one of those tougher, slippery heroes, and we saw that last time they had the Faceless Void against this combination. Eternal Envy was always fast enough with the fingers to be able to get the Shadow Dance off first. And I would say that this lineup is actually even harder. At least they had some sort of AoE last time to be able to throw it out under the Chronosphere. They have Invoker, but the single target focused Drow Ranger is going to be really hurt if that sort of situation happens again in this game 4.
Yeah, and this Invoker has to make as much use of this Drow Ranger aura as possible. They put a lot into this right now, as Puppy's going to make his way over to mid. Not really going to do too much out of this, and he's getting traded out. Doesn't really have a lot of HP regen to work with.
Well, the mid lane might not be going the greatest for Wii when it comes to regen. The CS is even, and there is a pretty big difference between our two offlaners. Mind Control actually trying to lane in the beginning of the game has slowed him down, while Misery completely giving up on that offlane and going for the Iron Talon first has a sizable advantage.
Yeah, that's why we see Puppy come in this mid lane and just try to tank up some of the hits, help out Wii with that aura, because he realizes the jungle's going to get pretty crowded, but I have to let the Beastmaster get as much harm as possible.
Mm-hmm. Which is where Pylai Dai also shows himself, as he took a quick trip over there between the Tier 1 and Tier 2 to see if he could spot out a courier, but now he's going to rotate all the way through behind Fada and see if he can eat one of these trees for a quick setup on a gank. Not going to happen, though. Liquid are playing pretty close to this mid lane as well. Mind Control's obviously doing some jungling, but Jerix has been sitting in the mid lane for some time as well.
Yeah, and Mind Control's going to not get a lot out of this jungle, as doesn't have a Quelling Blade or anything. Like, the Beastmaster immediately went for the Iron Talon. This is why he's getting so much out of this jungle right now. And laning phase-wise, Secret are getting so much more, actually.
Puppy puts himself in the mid lane once again. Looking to be able to get two denies before backing out. Eats one of the Fort Spirits, that'll certainly help out Weeha.
Nah, he's been doing a really good job, and you're already seeing it reflected. The Drow are barely being able to use in this lane, and hey, they're just going to fall behind right now. The pace of this game, once again, favoring Team Secret, is they're getting more out of every single one of their lanes. This bottom lane now, a level 4 Beastmaster is going to stroll in. This Puppy's going to make his move on Jerix.
Oh,
he gets the crit.
He's actually dealing a lot of damage to Jerix. He won't be able to get another crit. And that pressure at the bottom lane is met by the Beastmaster. They get no damage on that tower.
Yeah, and Fada trying to get aggressive here in this mid lane.
Oh, but he's
trying to make advantage
careful.
Of this draw up, but he's going to get caught on.
It's coming in from behind, bleeding with the Hex. The nice shackle shot set up by Weehaw. They're going to have to follow up, but Kuro is here with the heals. Nia has the shell grave, but a very fire. Whoa, Kuro doesn't even attempt the shell grave that could have saved Fada's life. I don't know what happened there, but that could have been a clear save on First Blood, preventing Secret from getting it.
Yeah, you even had Mind Control rotate over. That's going to be very costly as Kuro even rotates for that. And now in this bottom lane, because he had to rotate over, Misery's already level 5. This bottom tower's already being pressured by Eternal Envy, who's got his level 6. Once again, Matumba Man falling behind in levels. And it's starting to look, like the analyst said, a little bit bleak.
He definitely feeling when a Slark is able to pressure a tier 1 tower better than the Drow Ranger, and this all comes down to Misery's great start with the Iron Talon first, and nice cleanup there. That was level 1 Wild Axes that just took so many of those neutrals.
Misery has been playing the entire playoffs really brilliantly for Team Secret. I know he was a question mark coming into this tournament, but he has done so well and adjusted. Almost always gets more than the other offlaner, despite what he's playing.
Compares supports, Puppy is, despite, you know, constantly rotating into that mid lane, having a jungler like this is always going to allow them to take a bit of an experience and gold advantage.
Yeah. This Invoker is still doing okay against the Windranger mid. It's just not nearly as much as he expected. Mind Control's got the boots now on the Void too, but he just can't contest a Slark by himself. Whereas like the Drow Ranger has almost no offensive potential on this Beastmaster. And that's why you see Pylai die, I mean Puppy come down here now too.
Looks like it may take some time, so we can talk about perhaps some progression in this game. One big downside is they don't really have an offlaner that's going to be able to rotate and help Team Liquid's fortune in this mid lane, as Mind Control is still only level 4. So what does Team Liquid do to kind of offset this laning phase win for Secret?
Not entirely sure. The team fights are obviously going to have to be there, but you drafted so much for the lanes when you're Liquid. They have this Tusk that was meant to rotate around. The Dazzle is there to be for the Grave mid, but like Fada even has the Drora, but none of these things have been able to be abused. Still, things are looking somewhat okay right now for Fada. He is winning in CS and not that far behind the Windranger at all.
Do you like the Rod of Atos build again, or do you think faster Hand of Midas is more important for Liquid to be able to catch up in an overall net worth and experience?
Sort of think a faster Hand of Midas is a lot more important.
And what about our supports of Liquid? Do they just continue to focus on pulling? Because it seems like their rotations have been entirely ineffective.
Yeah. I think things right now are fine as they are. Liquid, they're going to have to be the ones to push the tempo soon. Like Tusk at some point is going to have to make some rotations over. The team fights are going to be pretty crucial for Liquid, as they don't have the best catch ability. They've got this Void, but we saw what happened in the first game when he was just kind of run ragged around the map. And this Invoker as well, he doesn't go for the Yules build for the one shot. So it's almost entirely going to be team fight dependent for Liquid. They were hoping to be able to snowball the lanes with the draw aura, for the Invoker at least, and make it easy for like this combo at bottom to be really successful, but Beastmaster instantly goes to the jungle. Iron Talon's on stop, almost picks up his level 6 already. He's got a lot of farm right now, he even has the Belt of Giant Strength, whereas the Void was not that quick to that. He decided he was going to lane for a little bit, and that cost him quite a bit.
Right.
He's really far behind on Faceless Void. He's like 600 gold behind the Beastmaster. And
kind of an interesting style that Puppy's playing with this Doom. He only has 5 CS. He actually hasn't spent that much time in the jungle at all. He's rotated mid quite a lot. We saw this the way that Dooms were being utilized in some of the group stage matches and where they would rotate in and devour out the whatever creep was being used by the Enchantress. But rotation into mid and taking away the Forge Spirit from the Invoker early on definitely sets back his ability to play aggressive on the Windranger.
Yeah, and they're showing something in the crowd, which I have no idea what.
If only it was in Korean.
I can't read that either.
Well, then you're useless to me.
Kind of. Oh, now they're showing the game again. Sweet. So we can talk about that again. I don't know. I know it's really early and premature, and as an analyst, or co-caster more importantly, it's hard to say this, but the team fights have to go really well for Liquid if they want to stand a chance.
Yeah, my control's got to be really spot on with his Chronospheres, and they have to hit every single, like, Sunstrike, Meteor Blast, Deafening Blast combination they can.
This style is so... Like, I don't know what the best way to put it is, but you apply pressure just by existing. Like, Liquid is always thinking, well, what about the Doom? He's just getting steady farm.
Right.
Well, if we don't do anything about the Beastmaster, how do we gank a Windranger who has Windrun when we don't have a lot of lockdown? EE is going to be nearly ungankable. We saw what happened when they tried to go for it last time with the Chrono plus Invoker.
He certainly got a lot of the crowd backing him, as you could see. EE Sama, no mercy signs everywhere.
He's not having any right now. Typically, with Eternal Envy, you almost always have one of those performances where you're just like, no, but in this Grand Finals, he's really showed up. I haven't seen that once. He's been so consistent.
If you guys can't tell, the atmosphere here in the Mercedes-Benz Arena has been electric all day long. I heard we had around 15,000 people here. I'm not sure if that's true, but it's certainly packed arena.
Yeah. The only seats that are unclaimed are the ones that are like at a weird angle for the screens. But the rafters are just like filled.
All right, FOD is excited. Let's play some Dotes.
Play some Dotes. That's what they're here for. At the end of the day.
Just five boys.
Yeah.
Fünf Jungs,
yeah. Just trying to play some Dotes. Try not to think about the atmosphere or what they're playing for.
Liquid, they're going to try again with this bottom lane push. The boar will be able to pull the creep wave off, and that's why they really need to kill it immediately. We'll be able to get back here to the enclosing creep wave, but mind control is being controlled off. Eternal Envy gets the kill there.
What a rotation by him. Just casually picks up a void by himself. It's mind control. That's going to be a rough death.
He's already having a hard enough time with his level progression. This is something that Eternal Envy has done twice now with this Slark.
Yeah.
Make the full rotation around the jungle, into the river, and into that offlane camp to try and catch out the offlaner.
And this is going to be a free tower for them. And this is two games in a row where Eternal Envy has not been contested whatsoever. He's been able to pick up this tower, and Secret have been able to contest their offlane tower. Like, they've done such a good job of keeping that offlane tower alive that it just slows down any momentum that Liquid can pick up.
Do you like the same builds as last time for the Slark?
Oh, they're even going to spot the rotation because of this ward placed out.
Oh,
this is so well done by Secret. Like, these guys have come to play for a championship right now.
Every strategy seems on point for Secret, as even Eternal Envy being given a ward is going to place it between the Tier 1 and Tier 2 in mid lane, so they'll see those rotations as well. Secret, those wards are so deep that even certain smoke ganks or rotations that are played very deep in this, the Radiant side of Liquid, are going to be scouted out.
Yeah, most of this vision is just analysis. Like, Secret are like, if they're not here, they're here.
Right.
And it's going so well as the Slark now picks up a hand of Midas. He's going to continue to climb way ahead of the Drill Ranger, who's a very static hero. This is not a hero that can go around and fight. This is a hero that essentially just wants to farm, push waves down, enable your teammates. But the Slark is going to be able to do whatever he wants in a game like this. He has teammates that have a lot of control. Secret continue to get ahead in the other two lanes as their Beastmaster is now barely behind the Invoker in net worth. Puppy's in a similar situation. And the two supports once again are falling so far behind from Liquid.
Yeah, they're right now sitting on mind control, but they're just taking away his experience. He needs level 6.
Yeah.
They need to get that first Chronosphere in the mid lane so Invoker can get something going here.
Eternal Envy picks up a Haste Rune, but he looks like he's just going to use that to farm. Smart decision by him is, again, Liquid, they don't have the best lineup to deal with the Slark. Almost similar to what they had last time. If anything, it's even harder for a Drow to do anything against the Slark.
Oh, FaZe Boots coming in for Weeha now as they may try and do something still with the last couple of seconds of this haze screen. It runs out now, but Eternal Envy is still going to go into the jungle.
Look at this. Like now they switch Pyoth to the safe lane, and this is why they've been picking the Lion. He's now level 6. He's even going to go bottom as Matumba Man.
The TP out, but that's going to be Zonda. Oh, maybe not. The silence is there, but the Primal Roar comes just out in time. They have the Shallow Grave. Matumba Man's going to start backing himself away. They have the Scorched Earth as well as the Poison to make sure that Matumba Man does end up dying. Puppy is pretty far forward here, but they're going to still try and catch him. He turns around looking for the Doom. He finally gets it off on the bottom. As the Turtle Heavy comes back into the fight to make sure that Jarrus goes down as well. Secret take full control of the Tier 1 tower on top of everything else. And they're even trying to run down another hero. Eternal Envy, though, is not going to be able to get there, but the tackle shot will be. Body gets locked down, taken out. 0-5, Team Secret. An amazing start here in game number 4 as they make the run for the championship.
Amazing. They've got 4 out of the top 5 net worth heroes. The only person on Liquid that's even kept up is the Drill Ranger that they just managed to nab. Everything going right for Secret right now. Everybody's getting so much on the map. Pi was given so much space after Envy just kind of shoves off the lane and says, I'll go roam. He even decides to place the ward for Pileidai. This is just vintage Secret right now. They're making so much efficiency out of the map.
Focus Fire not yet up. It's still on cooldown for another 20 seconds, but they're going to try and get some poke damage onto this Tier 2 before Liquid make their rotation over. But again, they have these kind of deep wards like the mid lane as well as very deep inside the jungle here that scan out these rotations pretty quickly.
Yeah, Secret right now are...
Smoke, Jarex.
They're not going to be able to
There's
get anything out of
this. There's no way they can kill with just the two of them.
Yeah, Weeha might even spot this as Mind Control time walks forward, but... they're going to have to do this pitch perfect. I don't think they have the damage for it either. Liquid are just getting frustrated. Their two supports are just not getting anything. Look at Pileidai. He's level 7. He's already got Arcane Boots with the Magic Stick and the TP Scroll. Bearing himself his own smoke and wards. Everybody just continues to farm. Like Secret are just playing Ring Around the Rosie. They're saying, okay, now we're here. Liquid makes the rotation. Then Secret immediately gets out and continue to waste time.
And the more items they farm up, the better they're going to be able to pressure some of these outer towers as the Beastmaster is coming in soon with the Necronomicon level 1.
Matumba Man and Vaughn are just committed right now. But Liquid, again, they can't kill this Windranger core.
Power shot comes through. They're going to try and force this Tier 1 down. But Secret are not going to give it up without a fight. Scorched Earth on Puppy is going to lead the way.
Everybody from Secret rotating in. Liquid have to be careful about this. And meanwhile, Misery doing the same thing as Mind Control did in his Beastmaster game. Putting pressure, getting his own amount of farm. That's already the full Necro 1 completed at 11 minutes for him.
He's had a great game, and it looks to only get better from here as Liquid just do not seem to be able to get at a successful gank rotation anywhere across the map.
Misery farming up everywhere that he can. What a performance by him. He's second in net worth on his team, barely behind the Drill Ranger. And nobody from Liquid can split farm or apply pressure quite like Secret's heroes can. Like, Matumba Man seems almost lost right now in this game.
Yeah, Liquid are spending so much time in their own jungle, but even that is being taken away by them as Eternal Envy is taking the right-hand side. Those three camps are going to be forfeit for Liquid. Seems like they're going to go for round number 2 and a Tier 1 tower push at mid, but at a certain point, Secret could even give this up just for positioning.
Yeah, they don't really care about this tower anymore. They've determined we're getting so much out of the map, it doesn't matter. Liquid have to show up as 5 just to do anything. Misery is going to take full advantage of this and continue to get farm. That Necro 2 is short to follow. Eternal Envy is kind of just walking around, creating space for his team. He's way too tanky to be isolated out, too.
They're trying to fight him here. Eternal Envy.
Jarex is only level 4 right now.
He has a pounce up in a second, should be able to get away. Still has a Shadow Dance ready to go as well. There's just no conceivable scenario where Liquid kill him there.
Yeah, Kuro even rotated over briefly, but Dazzle's not really going to be able to make anything happen as the Shackle latches. Vada's going to get gone on.
Beautiful stun lock.
Bot is taken out, and there goes the Finger of Death on Kuro as well. Needs to be able to get off the Shallow Grave. Will be able to just in time, but Liquid can't actually turn on these heroes. Well, maybe Kyla dies. Quickly sidesteps that Impale, will be able to kill him. Mind Control is controlled up, so he didn't actually get off a good opportunity for a Chronosphere whatsoever.
Yeah, that's the first kill of the game for Liquid, but again, like in the other games that they struggle against Secret, Secret are just splitting them around the map, running them ragged. Everybody continuing to farm on Secret as the mini engagements are working out for them right now.
Look at Eternal Abbey, he wants to force this, and he's doing so successfully. Mind Control actually has to head on back to the base at this point in time.
Yeah, Weeha not even going to get close to getting caught by that, and the mid tower is being taken by Misery.
Vada trying to land the Sunstrike on Misery, does actually land it, but it's not enough to get the kill, and now he'll die to Eternal Envy as another successful rotation from Secret. They just seem unstoppable at this point.
Yeah, he's almost got Necro 3 at 14 minutes into the game.
Oh, with the Beastmaster Hawk, they spot out Kuro, Puppy. He's gonna try and force another one. They have the pounce to be able to lock Kuro in. He doesn't even get off the Shallow Grave.
But Tama Man's gotta be careful too. Is Secret are just running roughshod right now over Liquid. They're being dived wherever they feel like it.
What does Liquid need to do to get something out of this map? They can't go in their jungle, they can't go mid, they can't go bottom. The top lane is so far pushed out that it's a risk for anybody to show up there.
I just don't think they quite have the heroes to be able to do this. They don't have a lot of like catch heroes. You've got the Faceless Void, but he's fallen so far behind. He's got 3,200 net worth, which is only even 1,000 behind Vada's. And this Chronosphere, this level 7 Chronosphere is not going to do anything.
No. Not a single Chronosphere has been seen so far in this game. And he's trying to go into the Vlads, but that just will not be enough of a damage build for Liquid, as he's going to run into Pylon Dai here, has the opportunity to finally get a Chronosphere, but Pylon Dai managed to get the Hex out first. Time Walk is coming in a second. And the rest
this
of his team is behind him.
You have to get this kill if you're Liquid.
Yeah, they're going to be able to get the Ice Shard. Oh! It pushes Pylon Dai out. They don't use the Chronosphere, but they also don't get that kill.
That's a five-man rotation, and what are Secret doing? Everybody continues to farm. This Slark has 9k net worth already. Matama Man is somehow keeping up with the rest of Secret's members, but Eternal Envy is pretty much untouchable as he sells it, grabs Treads and Assange instead, realizing I don't even need that. And Liquid are going to go for this tier 1 push at bottom, but Secret, they're going to smoke up. Looks like they want to wrap around. They've got full vision of this too with the wards.
They've got a 10k advantage by 16 minutes. They know they can fight this. And especially if they can get the surprise smoke initiation, take out one of these heroes real quickly. Jungle's a bit split. Secret are spread. They take out the courier first. Now Team Liquid know that they're in some sort of bind here as they're being surrounded by Team Secret.
There's no getting
Smushed
out of this.
They're
going to
go
fight.
Try and get the Doom. That doesn't go. I go off. They get off the Chronosphere, but it's still Eternal Envy. Goes straight from Matumba Man. The TP's out for Fada. He knows this fight cannot be won, but Primal War stops him. This could be Liquid all dying as Mind Control's the only one to be able to get away to the side and TP out. It looks like Jarek's going to go down as well as Puppy runs him down 1-13. Team Secret, the best performance they've had so far, and what a time to have it, too.
That was so well done from them. They hemmed in from every single side. The Slark playing the bait role because he knows he can't die. Secret have just executed this masterfully, and the last major, they were so close to being able to win it, get second at this one, but back-to-back top two, and it looks like at this rate, they're going to finish it off with a win.
Necronomicon number 3, Aegis, rolling in for Team Secret. If Eternal Envy wasn't impossible to kill before, now he truly is, with two lives on the table.
And Liquid, they're still struggling to get level 6 on Jarex right now. They're going to devote a lot of time to try to allow him to pick it up, but even then, it's not such a skill that it'll change anything in these fights. The Walrus Punch, not enough of a control factor against the Slark, who already has 1700 HP.
Even an Invoker is stalling out as he has yet to claim his Hand of Midas, as that was lost on the Courier much earlier.
Everything that could be going right for Secret right now is, and they're going to just continue to play off the farm game, even without too big of a major engagement. 12k
oh, nice.
Up to Shackle Land.
Weeha, the signature hero, is going to be able to control Mind Control almost long enough to get the kill. He gets a Time Walk and back up to full HP, but he needs still go down. Time Walk into the trees to TP out, and Eternal Envy can't get his claws on him.
But over in the mid lane, Pylai Dai is actually going to be surrounded. That's life number two now, as Liquid finally get themselves another kill.
If you're Liquid and you want to win this game, it has to just, it's going to come as a grind. It's got to be one kill at a time.
Liquid one kill at a time is what Eternal Envy's currently getting. Again, not even a shell grave used. Matamba Man's going to be able to be in here, but Eternal Envy knows he can fight. He has the Aegis, and some of his allies are rotating over.
Liquid are so scared to engage that Slark right now. Eternal Envy has free reign once again.
Mind control, is he actually going to go for it? Yeah, he does. He's got Misery locked in. Bafana isn't quite close enough
damage
to start laying up damage. Gets the Deathwing Blast out. Eternal Envy comes in from behind. And Bafana's actually going to die first. Yes, Mind Control gets the kill on Misery, but is he actually going to be able to get out? He cannot afford to lose the rest of his mana. Is able to time walk away, but Eternal Envy, oh, just not caring. He charges that tier 2.
He's like, I'm just going to farm instead. It doesn't really matter. I'm right in front of your tier 2 with a bunch of heroes, but Eternal Envy is so far ahead of the pack right now that he can really just afford to do this.
Puppy, is it finally going to be? No, it's still the casual buckler. He'll actually complete a Vlad's instead. So no mech whatsoever.
Yeah, they're just favoring being able to tank up against physical damage because that's primarily what Liquid have, especially with their one position core in this Drow Ranger.
A 19 and a half minute Hand of Midas. Obviously, the stat a bit skewed by the courier going down, but still just another nail in the coffin, it seems, for Team Liquid.
Yeah, right now Liquid, not really sure what their option's supposed to be.
Four-man smoke up.
You're just going to have to wait if you're Liquid for somebody to overextend, but Eternal Envy still has the Aegis available. Not the target that they want to go on. And Eternal Envy just denying creeps in front of Mind Control as well.
They're trying to bait Mind Control, but as soon as they see Eternal Envy, they realize this four-man smoke will never work out. Even if they did have a Chronosphere, I doubt it would be their way.
He's got the Talisman of Evasion too. And he knows that Bada is too far behind to be able to lock him down with spell damage. Neither of the supports have that either. And Secret, begin their mass assault at the top.
He just leads the charge here, forcing somebody to turn and fight him, but Liquid, full out retreat. They get some damage onto Eternal Envy. The Shadow Dance goes down the right hand side. Kuro's actually going to be locked up in the Shackle Shot. Weehaw with the double damage quickly finishes him off.
And he's going to win run back. As with the DD rune, there's no way that Liquid want to contest this, and the top tier 2 is going to go down at the hands of Eternal Envy. Once he gets a butterfly, which I imagine is the item from, they are going to be so hard pressed to stop him, maybe even splits out apart to get the Heaven's Halberd, which would completely shut down Matumba Man.
Blink Dagger up next for our Beastmaster. They could use a little extra initiation if they want it. Misery.
Do they really need it though?
You know, you gotta think about high ground initiation, I guess.
It's just like, at this point, Misery's just like, guys, I got it. And they're like, we don't care. We're ahead, don't worry about it.
Yeah. Weehaw with his Blink Daggers oftentimes been more than enough for the Shackle Shot, and if it isn't that, it's just Puppy running at them. What he's gonna do right now to Kuro, runs right into him. He wants to be able to hit the Centaur Stomp and actually doom up Kuro to make sure, again, there's no Shallow Grave response. And Eternal Envy's just daring Liquid to kill him at this point as the Aegis is going to expire soon.
Yeah, they're going to get this tier 2 tower before anything. This might be one of the quicker double, every single tier 2 tower's gone. And at most phases, a team would kind of just call it quits just because of the lineup disadvantage. But Liquid, they're going to battle it out because they know the stakes. But 15k net worth lead, XP is in a similar situation. I don't know what the stat is for that at just 22 minutes into the game, but I'd imagine it's pretty bleak.
Liquid, desperate for some sort of win here, go for the five-man smoke. And the sad part is Eternal Envy isn't even going to be there to farm.
And I know a lot of people are going to look at the score and say Liquid played bad, but this is just Secret executing their strategy to a T. Everybody knows how to move around each other. Every time you see somebody get gone on, the rest of the four aggressively start farming.
Even now, Team Secret had the read that Liquid, they're smoked up, and Team Secret are just all playing passive until Liquid finally reveals something to themselves.
Puppy's going to be the frontliner always for Team Secret. because Secret know that it takes Liquid way too long to just kill him.
Rest of Secret coming forward. The Blink Dagger's ready to go on Misery. They've got the Vision too. They're going to be able to lock down Matumbo. Man, the follow-up tackle. Trying to actually catch his spot in the background. They get the Snowball, able to provide a save there to the Drone Ranger, but they're still lacking damage. A good Meteor Deafening Blast combination, but Secret are just too damn big as they push forward. Mind Control with a saving Chronosphere to try and help the rest of its allies get the hell out of Dodge, but it's just not going to happen. They've lost three already, and looks like
fourth and Jerick's.
Beautiful play there from Pi. Once again, the Lion King proves that they take one fight, they win it, and Pylai Dai is always there to be able to find the extra kill.
3-21 is the score, as Bada's going to be the only one up, and Secret already getting aggressive at top as the Sunstrike comes out just to try to delay things, but Secret, they know they're so close. This one Rax is going to open things up already for them, and Liquid, they're all still dead with no buybacks available. It's a full set of racks gone at just 24 minutes into the game. They're going to immediately get out with nothing lost. Probably wait for the next racks to come up before they go for anything. Or the next Roche.
Right as Liquid come back up. Team Secret with the very clean escape. They're not risking anything. Blink Dagger, Butterfly, the list of items goes on and on for Team Secret.
Ags is about to complete two for Weehawk, and after that, I think Secret just wait for Roshan and continue to take objectives. An Eternal Envy, the demon that he is, he's going to go for Kuro. The crowd, they can feel it.
They want to see this kill happen. They want to see Eternal Envy go for the 1v3 play, and he will go for it. Kuro immediately the target of the Shadow Grave goes off first. Eternal Envy is now battling it out with four heroes, but now Puppy's going to be able to join them. He gets the Doom on him, a top of man, a snowball save for the moment being, but Eternal Envy's already cleaned up too, and now the chase begins. How many other heroes can they get? A nice long-range ice shards from Jerix. He knows he's giving up his own life, but he manages to save Matumba Man by blocking in Eternal Envy.
Yeah, and the Sunstrikes are going to fall too, but
still not enough. Another Shackle Shot! Weehaw! He showed it big in the Invoker play from last game, but now Weehaw's going to be able to make sure it's a total wipe, and there it is! Congratulations, Team Secret take game four in one of the most dominant fashions we've seen in the Grand Finals.
They were denied their first turn at Frankfurt, but they're successful here in Shanghai behind a crowd who are absolutely behind this team. 100% of the way, every single time, Jackie showed him.